Sunday morning, you see the semi-finished product, amen. You don't get to see a rehearsal today. Well, we blow each other eyeballs, right? They're praying for one another. Doesn't hit a note right, amen.
That's right.
Relationships, real love does, amen. The Bible says that love endures all things, amen. And I really do like the way that you guys work together. I like the way that you love on each other.
Israel. So Naaman came
with his horses and his chariot, and stood at the door of the house of Elisha. And Elisha sent a messenger to him, saying, go wash in the Jordan 7 times, for thy flesh shall come again to thee, and thou shalt be clean. But Naaman was wroth, and he went away. And wroth means he was angry. And he went away and said, behold, I thought he would surely come out to me, stand and call on the name of the Lord his God, and strike his hand over the place and recover the leper. Are not Abana and Phaphar rivers of Damascus better than all the waters of Israel? May I not wash in them and be clean? So he turned and went away in a rage. And his servant came near and spake unto him and said, my father, if the prophet had bid thee do some great thing, wouldst thou not have done it? How much rather then when he said thence, wash and be clean? Then he went down and dipped himself in the Jordan according to the saying of the man of God, and his flesh came again unto the flesh of a child, and he was clean. May the Lord have a blessing upon the reading of his holy and his divine word. And I want to preach on the subject this morning, how to determine if your butt is too big. How to determine if your butt is too big. Let us pray. Gracious and eternal God, our Father, God is now and again to be coming, your precious and everlasting name. We pray, God, that you might bless us beyond measure, that you might speak to us, God, that you might speak through us. For God, we pray that you might hear our word. Jesus' name for Christ's sake. And all the believers declare, hallelujah.
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 And amen.
There's always a but in every fortune. Like so many who spend a lifetime pursuing life's lofty goals, Naaman was troubled. Because in spite of his successes, Naaman was not well. He had been stricken with leprosy, a disease that will ultimately cost him his job, his money, and even his life. A disease that once discovered by his superiors would earn him a place in a cave on the outskirts of the city. A place where he would lose all contact with the world. Some of us have been where Naaman is. You felt like you had it all. A new position, a new car, a new home, a great home. Everything was going your way. And then all of a sudden, bang! Something happened. Some tragedy or some challenge hit you like a ton of bricks. A word from the doctor that you need surgery, some diagnosis that some deliberating the disease, signs of cancer, blood pressure, danger to have, concern that you're about your blood work and the test results that might be coming back. Maybe your employer had filed for bankruptcy. Maybe your child found himself on the other side of the law. Maybe you have suspicions that your wife or your husband may be cheating. You're on top of the world only to have something happen to remind you of how fragile your life is. That stuff will happen in your life and my life.
Amen.
You can imagine how Naaman must have felt. He was on top of the world until he developed leprosy. Now the job, the authority, the wealth. All Naaman could think about was sickness and death. If only he could have been healed of the leprosy. So a Naaman's distress. God sends a message to Naaman. Y'all hear that? God sends a message to Naaman. No TV, no telephone. But God sends a message. No emails. No texts. But God sends a message. No Verizon, no Infinity X. No CBS, no CNN, no ABC. But God sends a message. I know some of y'all waiting for God to text y'all.
Amen.
Tell y'all what to do next. Amen. But it ain't going to happen like that. Amen. Amen. But God sends a message for a little Israelite girl, a captive in his household. God sends a message of hope.
Amen.
The girl tells Naaman's wife about a prophet who could heal Naaman of his leprosy. Now watch this. The message didn't come straight to Naaman, but it came through Naaman's wife. Let me say that again. So some of y'all ain't get that. The message didn't come straight to Naaman, but the message came through Naaman's wife.
Amen.
Husband, listen to your wife.
Amen.
But God knows how hard-headed we as men can be sometimes. So what God has to do, God has to backdoor information to us.
Amen.
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 Through our wives. Amen.
Amen.
While we trying to hush up, God trying to send a message through us.
Right.
Amen. 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 I know you big man, good friend of the house. Amen. But God is trying to get a message to you.
That's right. That was
fast. But that's another sermon, amen. Amen. So Naaman goes to the king who follows protocol and sends a letter for Now he's asking the king to heal his friend. But the king recognizes his power. Y'all, some of y'all missed that. The king recognized his power. He recognized that his power was governmental and not God.
Come on.
So the king, filled with fear and indignation, he rinsed his clothes and he started to pray. This morning, America is headed towards a fiscal cliff.
Amen.
Because the Democrats and Republicans, the Independents, the Tea Party, President Obama, the Speaker of the House, Boehner, everybody needs to rip their clothes.
Yes.
And recognize that some stuff the government can't do. There's some stuff that is God's territory.
Uh-huh. That's right. That's right.
Marriage is God's territory.
Amen.
The government has no business to tell me what a marriage is.
Amen.
God has already determined what a marriage is. Abortion. It's God's territory.
Amen.
Hello. Homosexuality is God's territory.
Amen.
Amen.
Church is God's territory.
Say something.
I don't need the government to try to dictate to me how to run no church. No, in the Holy Ghost. Don't tell me how to run it. I ain't gonna run it.
Yeah.
The government has no authority to dictate or mandate anything to the church.
Amen.
We're not just headed towards a fiscal cliff, but we are headed towards a moral cliff. And a moral cliff is worse than a fiscal cliff.
Wow.
I'd rather lose my money than lose my soul.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So the text said, watch this. The text said Elijah heard about Naaman's visit and the king's fear for ransom. So Elijah, the man of God, watch this. Elijah, the man of God, offered to help the king, the man of government.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen. And he tells the king, you out of your lead. Send Naaman to me.
Oh boy.
The government needs to stay in their lane.
Amen.
Amen. The government is in the wrong lane. So Naaman goes to see the king. And the king gives Naaman an address.
Yes.
Tells him to go to Elijah's house. Mm-hmm. So watch this. Naaman arrives at Elijah's house.
Let's say so.
With an impressive entourage of power and wealth. A caravan of chariots.
Amen.
Down, bring it down.
A ceremony, like the red carpet action, if you will.
Amen.
And Elijah doesn't even go out there to shake his hand. That's right. Mm-hmm. Elijah don't even go out the house to shake his hand. Most preachers are impressed to be in the presence of the president. But in reality, the president ought to be impressed to be in the presence of the preacher.
Go ahead and ask.
Yep.
Hello, somebody.
Right now.
God has given the preacher a greater authority than the president.
Well,
amen.
Don't you know, next time you go sick, get sick, go ask the president to pray for you. Amen. going to restore life back to you. Elijah sends a messenger out, a human text message, to tell Naaman to follow these instructions. Go wash 7 times in the muddy Jordan River. If you follow these instructions, you will be healed and clean. And Naaman was beside himself. Tell me, go wash them. The nasty, dirty, muddy Jordan River. Naaman was beside. Naaman went plumb crazy. That's right. The text said he was raw. He was so angry that he left.
Uh-huh.
Naaman would say, I come all of this way for some quack crazy preacher to tell me to go wash in a nasty Jordan River. It would make more sense for me to wash in the clean river of the Damascus. Naaman right.
Yes.
Was saying, but he don't know who I am.
Well,
what? I'm not just going to hit nobody. I'm not just some leper. I'm not just a pawn or rook or knight. I'm a bishop. I want you to get blessed. I want to get blessed, but I'm not going for all of that. I want to get closer to God, but you need to look at your butt. I want to get closer to God, but I'm not going to Sunday school. I'm not going to Bible study. But what if the man of God told you, in order for you to get blessed, you got to come to Sunday school 7 times. You got to come to Bible study 7 times. You got to come to church 7 times. What if the man of God told you that? But
yes, sir.
I want a financial blessing, but I'm not going to tithe. Hello, somebody. You want a financial blessing, but you want to steal from God.
Well,
that don't make sense to me. It seems like to me that if you want a financial blessing, you want to at least do what God tells you to do. In Malachi 3:10, it said, if you do it like a man, I will open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, you may have grown up to see. Well, a man robbed God, but you have robbed me and tired and off. And receiving me, that at least you're going to do, if you're obedient to God's word, to get the blessing that you asked for. I want God to bless my home. But we never have the most sweet, we never have prayer time in our house. But you want God to bless your house. Something ain't clicking here, preacher. Something not making sense. God is trying to bless you, but your butt is too big. too often, we miss our miracle because we refuse to believe God's power to overcome any circumstance. We miss our miracle because we refuse to take a simple direction from God, simple direction from the man of God. God has a cure for our circumstance, but God has a solution for our suffering, but God has an assurance for our anguish, but God has a promise for our pain, but maybe you can't get a blessing because your butt is so enormous that you can't see the glory of God. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Your butt shall never be larger than God's ability to bless you. You do not understand that God can resolve and reduce the butts in your life. You get to realize God can change your butt. For he said, weeping may endure for a night, but because your butt is too big.
Thank you.